Where's behind you there? Down there. Brandon! Brandon, do you know who I am?
No.
I'm one of the men that you accused of taking a bribe, right, from Irish Water.
Right? What's your name?
Did you bring the evidence with you?
What evidence?
About the evidence that you have for accusing me.
Oh, do you mind me asking who you are?
Why?
I'd like to know.
You should know, because you accused me.
I never saw you before in my life.
Did you not?
No, not that I can recall.
The high courts, right, you stood beside me many a time, going on about that bloody section 21, agenda 21.
I never spoke about agenda 21.
You did. The high
local
court.
Agenda 21.
Local agenda 21.
The Harris Convention.
Yeah, that is that shite as well.
Yeah, no, but it's that shite. It's about your opinion.
Now 9.4, explain it to me.
I will. 9.4 is, you have heard of the Water Framework Directive?
I have, yeah.
But in the Water Framework Directive, there's a clause in it known as the polluters pay principle.
Yeah.
Right? Which means that the polluters has to pay for the water they pollute.
That's correct.
Yeah. Now, when that was being negotiated in Brussels, Cathy Simmons was our MEP, and she argued the point that the use of water for domestic use was a natural thing.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And as such, could not be deemed as pollutant. Right?
Yeah.
So she argued her point and won what has been known since as the Irish exemption, the 9.4 exemption, which means that the water that's used for human consumption, which is domestic water, cannot be charged.
Yeah.
Right?
That's right.
Now, that has been there all along. So when the water protest starts, as you know yourself, the water meters were being put into commercial
premises. I'm one of the nine that was taken up to an injunction.
As you know yourself. The water meters.
So the question we're asking is, why did you accuse people of taking bribes in the High Court?
Just one moment.
That's the question we're asking. You're waffling on here.
Look,
but we first asked you why you accused the nine people of taking bribes in the High Court. Where you got your evidence and how you got the evidence with you?
I asked you on Facebook to bring it with you.
I never saw it on Facebook.
You did, because you blocked me yesterday.
What's your name?
And I took you off the...
I blocked Mark Egan yesterday, that's all I blocked you.
And why did you block these people? Because they're telling the truth, or because you don't like what they're saying?
They're abusive.
They're not.
And they're posting under false names.
I'm not under false names.
And you won't even tell me what your name is.
Hector.
Oh, Hector Dwyer.
Yeah.
I haven't you blocked.
You have me blocked. You blocked me the other day.
You accused this man of taking a bribe.
And you accused me of taking a bribe.
What defence did he put up in the High Court?
What defence could we put up?
That you had the 9.4 exemption.
That's a load of nonsense. That's nothing to do with what was going on.
It has everything
had nothing to do with what was going on.
Why would
right?
it have something to do with
GMC Sierra was pinging up to the High Court
for blocking,
right, for blocking the meters.
Going into
right?
domestic houses.
9.4. Right, had absolutely nothing to do with it.
It had everything to do with it.
It had nothing to do with it.
I was trying to explain to you before that, and I interrupted it. The water meters were started being put in 2010. They were being put into commercial premises. You look at them all.
Actually,
here.
Before that.
Before that, yeah. And the business interests were paying for their water. They had no problem with that.
That's correct.
The protest started when they started putting in the meters into domestic houses.
That's correct, because I was one of the first ones to do it.
Yes, because the people that started protesting knew that they could not charge for domestic water or 9.4 exemption.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
So it was all to do with the 9.4 exemption.
What has that got to do with me taking a bribe at the High Court? That you accused me and seven others.
And other people have said that bribes, there's evidence, I don't have it, of Derek Byrne and Bernie Hughes taking a backhander from somebody else. Colin McGettrick has it.
No, he hasn't got it.
Yes, he has.
No, he hasn't got it. No, he hasn't got it.
I can ring him up in the street.
Right.
Tell
well, then why did he accuse everyone of doing it then if you only mentioned those two names now?
At the time, I thought everyone took it.
Exactly. You talked. Exactly. That's what I'm trying to say.
I want to ask you another question. How much did RT pay you for the Apollo House story?
The setup
of the Apollo House story. How much did RT pay? Now I have it from an inside source that RT paid you, so don't start shouting on about you.
It was set up all right, because it wasn't
you have it from that somebody paid me.
Pay group of you to stand outside that building for that story.
That's a lie.
Well, how come you were there just as RTE was there?
We'd arranged to meet RTE on that day to discuss other business. I can tell you,
RTE turned up.
I'm not 100% sure how they came to me there. I didn't do the interview.
Huh? You were sitting in the middle of it.
I was sitting in the middle of it.
Yeah, but like kind of, we're going on about the homeless, yes. Right? You keep dragging down Apollo House.
What happened in Apollo House? Why did they surrender Apollo House?
Why did he? Because it was the injunction told him to get out. There's
the
no.
You know it yourself. There was an injunction got against you, right?
Yeah.
You were one of the 9 people named in that first injunction.
That's correct.
The injunction was only against those 9.
Yes.
So there was only 4 people named in the injunction in Apollo House.
That's right.
So there was only 4 people in jail.
That's right.
So why did the rest of them leave?
Because they voted to leave.
There's only
you are trying to drag down Apollo House.
I'm not.
Right?
I'm
you
not
are trying to drag it down.
But I thought I was trying to drag down Apollo House.
That's what we want to know. That's what we
and
want
I'm
to know.
You
badmouthing Apollo House.
I'm asking
since it started.
Why did the surrender Apollo House?
No, you're accusing.
Accusing them of what?
Of walking out. You are dragging. You are dragging down Brendan Ogles big time.
Brendan Ogles went in and he agreed. He sent in a submission to the commissioners. He sent in a submission to the commissioners saying that we should all pay for our water through our taxes.
No, he did. Yes.
Yes, he did.
Yes.
That.
We're paying through our taxes as it is.
Well, do you want to pay for the water through your taxes?
We are paying through our taxes.
Yes, but with our 9.4 we wouldn't have to pay for domestic water at all.
But we're paying for it through the taxes. That's what
we're actually
that's not. What
we're
we
not.
Are paying through
we're
our taxes.
We're paying for the infrastructure.
This is the argument we have with yourself.
Okay, how much are we paying for water?
What? Through our taxes.
How much?
Whatever tax you pay.
How much?
At the moment, nothing.
But then we're not paying.
True, except you can't even say how much we're paying.
We're not paying for water. I know we're not.
We're paying water to our taxes.
We're paying for the infrastructure.
And car tax.
We're paying for the infrastructure of the water services. That's what we're paying. We're not paying for water. We're not paying X amount per litre.
I know, that's because we stopped them.
No, we didn't stop them.
We did stop them.
And you weren't there.
At the end of the month, right, they're going to stop temporarily to put meters in.
They've stopped.
Now, I don't believe they're going to stop completely.
They've stopped. What they have done, and it came out the other day, you heard it yourself, they put a cap on our 9.4 exemption. 125 litres.
They put a cap on everything.
123 litres is the cap on our 9.4 exemption.
That's what they're saying.
Yes.
You are going on Facebook as if it's facts. It's not facts. You come along, right? And if someone says boo to you, the moon is brown, right?
Yeah.
You will agree with them, and you'll go to hell. You do agree to everyone. You don't make a decision yourself. All you do all the time is copy and paste. Right? I've asked you many a time.
Right. You've asked me to explain the 9.4 exemption to you,
and you totally ignored me on social media.
I'm not ignoring you now.
No, that's because I'm standing in front of you. I know everything about what a 9.4
is. And why did you use it in court then?
Huh?
Because
9.4 had nothing to do with Dennis O'Brien, GMC Sierra, taking me to the High Court.
And what were your charges with in the High Court?
Huh? For interfering with GMC Sierra. That
putting
has nothing
meters.
To do. No, the 10 metres came, 20 metres actually.
No, for putting in water metres. You're
water
in
meters. Yes. What? Right? Nothing to do with selling water or buying water or giving water away, right?
Well, was your defence in? Sorry for asking this question. Was your defence that you were against the water meters going in because they were toxic?
We were against the water meters going in, full stop. any reason, made no difference.
Yeah.
Right? Any reason, we were against putting in the water meters.
Well,
and
why
the boxes.
Did you use, the question then would have to be, why didn't you use the
We weren't there to bring in GMCA. We weren't there bringing GMCA to the car.
No, it was the Iraqi.
Then what? Right?
Yeah, but
now for us to have, say what you're trying to say, is what I'm trying to say to you on Facebook, was that we'd have to bring them.
No, you could have used what I'm saying
you
as
cannot.
A defense.
You cannot. What, 9.4?
Yes.
You can't.
Why wouldn't you?
You can't.
You
or the Geneva Convention. You couldn't
could have
use
used, you could have used the precautionary principle as a defense.
You couldn't.
Why wouldn't you?
Right, they were bringing us personally to court. Right?
I was injuncted.
For us.
I know what injunctions are about. I was in the High Court. On a different matter.
On a different matter. It's something to do with a dump down in Galway.
Yeah.
Well, back to the point of you slating an army men and women who stood up for the communities online, blacking in the names because of hearsay that you got.
Hearsay?
No actual facts. Hearsay.
Actual facts.
You slated men and women who stood in the rain, in the snow, been punched, been attacked, been harassed by Gardaí on Facebook.
I got hit by a digger.
In the comfort of your keyboard, you slated these people on hearsay. On stuff you hear from other activists who haven't got the balls to say people's faces. You've done it from your laptop.
You finished?
Nope. You attacked Bernie Hughes, verbally, and online you attacked Eric Moore, two of the most hard-working activists I've ever met in my life, and you had the balls to attack them online. I've been involved in the water movement for 3 years since the start, and it's the first time I've ever seen you stand on a street with a sign in your hand. You talk bollocks.